redemption about. And today I was reading the scriptures, and I would like to share with you what God was telling me this morning. And this is in 2 Peter chapter 3, verse 3. Most importantly, I want to remind you that in the last days, scoffers will come, mocking the truth and following their own desires. They will say, what happened to the promise that Jesus is coming again? From before the time of our ancestors, everything has remained the same since the world was first created. They deliberately forgot that God made the heavens by the word of his command. And he brought the earth out of the water and surrounded it with water. Then he used the water to destroy the ancient world with a mighty flood. And by the same word, the present heaven and the earth have been stored up for fire. They are being kept for the day of judgment when ungodly people will be destroyed. But you must not forget this one thing, dear friends. And that is, like 1,000 years to the Lord, and 1,000 years is like a day. The Lord isn't really being slow about his promise, as some people think. No, he is being patient for your sake. He does not want anyone to be destroyed, but wants everyone to repent. But the day of the Lord will come as unexpected as a thief. Then the heavens will pass away with a terrible noise, and the very elements themselves will disappear in the fire, and the earth and everything on it will be found to deserve judgment. Since everything around us is going to be destroyed like this, what holy and godly life you should live. Looking forward to the day of God and hurrying it along. On that day, he will set the heavens on fire and the elements will melt away in the flames. But we are looking forward to a new heaven and a new earth he has promised, and a world filled with God's righteousness. It is very important, friends, to be in the Word of God and to get into the Scriptures, because like the Scripture was saying, there's many people that are going to be coming, you know, in the end times to try to contaminate the Word of God, change it, and try to make people believe that Jesus is not coming and, you know, there's not going to be any wrath and so forth. And I believe that, you know, his second coming is going to be very soon. And we need to be ready. We need to be righteous before God and respect God and, you know, furthermore, repent from our sins. Because just like, you know, God destroyed people in Sodom and Gomorrah when they were living their, you know, daily lives and, you know, in the time of the flood and so forth, he's going to come again. And those of us that are not walking correctly with Jesus and in the world are going to be destroyed. So that's something to reflect this morning. God bless you.